I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
All right.
I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad, he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
Let's sing that again. He has made me.
He has made me glad, he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad, he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
I will enter.
I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. Oh, he has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice. He has made me glad. He has made me glad, he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
He has made me.
He has made me glad, he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
Lord of lords, King of kings, worthy to be praised, worthy to be lifted up. We give him praise and honor and glory. And we thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Let's call out a name this morning. Yes. 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 God, we know that where two or three are gathered together, that you're in the midst. Where two or three agree, God, we agree right now in the name of Jesus. We plead your blood right now in the name of Jesus. We give you praise. We give you honor. And we give you glory. Let's just have a special prayer for mothers right now. We pray for mothers everywhere in this building. God, we pray for people that for the first year, this is the first year without their mother. And God, we pray for people in this building and under the sound of my voice, God, that they've lost children. But Father, I plead your blood. I thank you for mothers. I thank you, God, that we have set a special day aside to just say we thank you, mothers. Father, we give you the praise for mothers this morning. What about unspoken requests? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Let's give him praise. Let's be seated for a moment. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise God for mothers. Amen. 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 They built this nation. Did you know that? Mothers, they're part of it all. A part of it all. I wanted to relate this morning to finances and, you know, our giving to the Lord. Mothers, you know, praise God for you, and I'm gonna charge you this morning with a little bit of responsibility here. Mothers, especially stay-at-home moms or any mothers, you have a huge responsibility in finances that are taught to the children. You probably spend the majority of the time. Of course, there are some fathers that spend a lot of time as well, but we'll charge them on their day. But today, like, for instance, this week, my children, you know, we pick up mayhaws that are in the yard and sell them, and that's the kids' money. Well, rather than just, you know, we can run down to Dollar General and spend it like crazy, rather we're going to take a 5 or a 10% or whatever, a portion of that, and, you know, my wife, a mother, she says, okay, well, here's this. We're going to take this much. We're going to put this in the piggy bank. We're going to take this much, and you can go spend this. And we're going to take this much, we're going to put it in the offering this next Sunday. You see, you teach this from a child. So I'm charging the mothers this morning, when finances, nobody else is going to teach your children. They don't do this in the schools. Praise God, they may one day, but currently I was not taught this. You know, this is taxed. You're going to get taxed on this. We call that a dad tax. We take in, we go buy ourselves something. No. But mothers have a big part in this. And you can teach your children to grow up godly. You can teach them in finances. And you can do all of this in the name of Jesus, out of the scripture. And it's even more so here. You know, empower the next generation at this church to overcome poverty, to live in the prosperity of God, to understand finances and how to walk inside of the blessings of God that we've been given here. So, Father, right now we just pray your blessing over these mothers, Father, that they would just continue just to lift up your name. They'd seek you and find you in all of the ways that they mother in mothership. Lord, we pray for them. Lord Jesus, we pray for the finances here. Lord, you're going to, God, if there's a seed given, God, we're going to believe for that hundredfold return, Lord. It's going to produce, and there's going to be so much that's just brought forth here, and it's all going to bring you, Jesus, what you did at the cross is going to bring all of that glory. And we love you for it, Lord Jesus. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. I was asked to sing a song for the offering today. I'm sorry for speaking just a little bit, y'all, but this is sort of a praise, is that our God is amazing, amen, and he's our provider, right? Well, I work every week. I work hard. I'm a bricklayer, and I work out in the hot sun. And this past week, I was figuring up. I knew how much money that I was going to make, you know, from my job. And I was like, Lord, I had a number in my mind that I wanted. Well, I guess this was last week, actually, last Sunday or whatever. But I was thinking of a number in my mind that I wanted. And I was thinking about, I knew what I was going to make from my job this week. And it wasn't to that number yet. Well, then I had someone called me, another church had called me to do some service for them. And they paid me as well, and it got me just a little closer to that number that I was thinking in my head that I had asked for. And it was right there, and I was like, and it was almost there, and I was thinking, you know what, God, you're going to amaze me. I just know you are. You're going to make that extra little money coming in. I wonder how it's going to happen. Well, I got a call Thursday, and someone had asked me to sing at a funeral. And I learned a song for them. This song that I'm going to do for you. And whenever I did it, I did it just simply because they asked me to do it. They asked me how much I would charge, and it's absolutely zero. I'm doing it because you asked me, and I appreciate the opportunity, right? Well, then I got paid, and didn't expect anything. Didn't even count it when they handed it to me, just stuck it in my pocket. Well, then I finally ended up getting back around to counting it, and it wasn't just that number, but it went over what I wanted. So exceedingly and abundantly more than we could ever ask. Am I right? Moonbeam shining keeps reminding of the journey I'll be taking soon. Nothing binding, I am pining for the journey that will take me over the moon. I'm sailing through above the blue and flying through the heavens blue and to. I'm hoping you decide to choose and sail the Milky Way with me. And ride above the sky, nor can be tied. I'm satisfied, and now I'm longing, and I'm hoping. I have no time for moping, for soon I will be floating away above the moon. I'm sailing through above the moon and flying through the heavens blue and to. I'm hoping you decide to choose and sail the Milky Way with me and ride at Jesus' side. Nor can be tired, I'm satisfied. I have no time for moping, for soon I will be floating away above the moon.
Amen.
All right, amen. Let's give the Lord another hand clap of praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Are you ready for the journey? Well, on a journey now, so be ready to go. You can be packed. We're over the moon. Isn't that right? In the name of Jesus. We're excited to get started for Vacation Bible School. It's going to be June the 13th through the 17th. And there's a sign-up sheet in the old foyer of the sanctuary. And we're excited to see what God's going to do. So we're excited about Vacation Bible School. Vacation Bible School is a wonderful time. We have a great time, don't we, Miss Judy, all over this building. And so you be a part of that. Sign up sheet. There's a meeting and there's a material handout this Wednesday, 18th at 5. Is that this Wednesday, the 18th? Next. Okay, it's the next Wednesday. I'm sorry. It'll be a handout on May the 18th. All right. We got another announcement, don't we? Okay.
I got a mic. Okay, so I wanted to share with you a couple of opportunities. Both of them have to do with the youth. And one is that we are asking for people that would like to share or would be willing to share with the youth on Wednesday night. Our thought process is that we want to let the youth get to know their church family, and we know that y'all have a wealth of wisdom that you could share with them. So if you'd be willing to do that, you can share for 5 minutes or you can share for 45 minutes. It's strictly up to whatever the Lord lays on your heart. You can share a testimony. You could share some advice. You could share a lesson. Whatever you want to do, but there's a sign-up sheet in the foyer, and we've got spots open that we would like for people to volunteer to share with our youth on Wednesday night. The other is what Michael announced last Sunday. Just to give you a little more information, and in case you weren't here, we are planning a church-wide retreat. Will be from a Friday night at 6 and end about 6 o'clock on Saturday. Having said that, you don't have to spend the night if you don't want to do that, because it's going to be at the Church of God campgrounds in Pollock. So it's within driving distance that you could drive if you didn't want to spend the night. That's going to be on July the 15th and 16th. We'll have things planned, like there will be worship services, just like church services. There'll be three of those, one Friday night, Saturday morning, and Saturday afternoon. There'll be lots of time to visit. You know, we don't take enough time to fellowship and enjoy one another in today's world. So there'll be time for you to visit with people that are there and just enjoy being relaxed. We'll also have a few recreational things planned that are appropriate for all age groups, which you can participate in, or you can just cheer on your favorite team or player or whatever, and you'll get more information about that. The cost is $15 per adult. Kids are free. And the youth are going to be working it, so we're not charging for them, of course, either. The deadline to sign up is the end of this month, the end of May, Sunday, May 29th. And we really need for you to sign up because we have to plan meals and housing and that sort of thing. We will try to house families together because we want this to be a family-oriented thing. So we would put families together as far as the housing lasts that way. And if you have any questions, just please feel free to ask, because we really hope this will be a unique time for our church to grow in the Lord and also a great time for our youth to serve you as our church family. So both the sign-up sheet for Wednesday nights and the sign-up sheet to go on the retreat are in the foyer of the old building. Thank you.
Amen. And next week, we start at 10:30, all right? There's going to be no Sunday school, no men's meeting. We start at 10:30. We're going to have singing. You're going to really enjoy. Avery Michaels is going to be with us, and I know that he's going to be a blessing to us, but we're also going to be a blessing to him. We need to worship and praise, and we need to get involved with that. And we're going to eat. We're going to have a catered meal, catfish. Everything's catered. You don't have to bring one thing. Just show up. And so I hope that you come. We're looking to feed at least 200 people. All right? Invite somebody to come. I want to welcome you once again. We welcome our visitors today. We welcome you mothers. It's good to have our daughter with us and John with us today. And I'm excited about what God is doing today. So let's just get, so many people have asked me about why we're not going on vacation, but we have changed that a little bit, and we're going to go. We're going to go to several places, and we're going to have a good time. I'm still reading the Book of Solomon, and you can't get enough of that for a vacation like we're going to go on. So I'm excited about what God's going to do. Hey. All right. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Let's all stand this morning.
I've got a little outbuilding at my house, about an 800 square foot like apartment thing, and me and Lamar are fixing that up for him to come stay at my house. Thought number one would always be me. I thought I could be what I wanted to be. I thought I could be
on life's sinking sand, but I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high and the valleys too wide. Down on my knees, I've learned to stand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. I thought I could do a lot on my own, and I thought I could make it all alone. And I thought of myself as a mighty big man, but Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high and the valleys too wide. Down on my knees, I've learned to stand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. I think I'll make Jesus my all in all, and when I'm in trouble, on his name I'll call. If I don't trust him, I'd be less than a man. 'Cause Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hands. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high and the valleys too wide. Down on my knees, I've learned to stand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand.
Sing that again.
Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high and the valleys too wide. Down on my knees, I've learned to stand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my
I will.
middle of the storm. Louder and louder, you're gonna hear my praises roar.
Storm, louder and louder, you're gonna hear my You took them all. There's not a trace. I stand here free with every stain. Forever washed away. I stand here free.
Let everybody get to your seats. Just let everybody get rested, get settled in the house of the Lord. Everybody excited to be in the house of the Lord today?
Oh, yeah.
Amen. 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 Happy Mother's Day to all you mothers. You deserve a pat on the back, especially for you teenage parents. You parents who have teenagers, that's what I'm trying to say. Or vice versa, either one. But a good mother kind of reminds me of a Brammer cow.
Amen.
Am I okay? Am I okay? Am I okay? And why I say that is because if any of you know what a Brammer cow is, their tendencies, their qualities, their traits, all that, let me just explain real quick to you. You can cross a Brammer cow with any kind of other cow, and you got you something. You have something very valuable. The highest cow on the market is a Brayford cow. That's a Brahman and a Hereford cross. They are very, very valuable. So, there's value, right? There's value. Okay? A Brammer cow can survive in any kind of environment. They can survive anywhere. They can survive just about anything. They withstand insects. They withstand the climate, the things that nature throws at them, they can survive it. But, how do I say this? They can be a little crazy. They can be a little bit crazy. They can be a little bit crazy. Especially when you mess with them babies, right? Especially when you mess with them calves. And I'm not putting anything on you mothers. I'm just trying to loosen you up, loosen your hearts up. But a Brammer cow, good cow, but you better watch them, especially if you mess with their babies. So, bless all you mothers in this house. Thank y'all. Thank y'all. Thank every one of you. Thank every one of you who serve in this church, who serve in the communities. Thank y'all. Keep it on. Keep up the good work. So, this morning, turn to Psalms chapter 51. Psalm 51, and this is a psalm of repentance. This is a psalm of, it was believed, I believe, to be written by David, sung by David, talked, whatever he did, whenever he got Bathsheba, whenever he sent his men to bring Bathsheba to him, and then he sent, and was it Ammon, or Uriah. He sent Uriah out to be slain in the front line of the battle because David had a lot of guilt built up in him. And then Bathsheba conceived a child. She conceived a child, and that child did not make it because of iniquity. So stand if you would. Psalms 51. I'm going to start in verse 10. I'm going to start in verse 10. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me by your generous spirit. And then I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall be converted to you. Now, jump to verse 16 and 17. These are the verses that we're going to expound upon today. Verses 16 and 17. For you do not desire sacrifice, or else I would give it. You do not delight in burnt offering. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart. These, O God, you will not despise. Father, thank you. Thank you for today, Lord. God, I pray, Lord, that ears are open today, Lord, that hearts are open today, Lord, for truth that will set them free. Lord, I pray for an impartation today of truth and of wisdom and of a revelation of knowledge of who you are, Lord. I pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. So David, he also, I didn't really mean to read over this, but I just want to touch on this real quick. I'm going to try not to keep you long today, but at the same time, I have a lot on my heart, and I believe and trust 100% in the Holy Spirit's going to draw it all out, bring it all out. But in verse 5, David says, "Behold, I was brought forth in iniquity, and in sin my mother conceived me. Behold, you desire truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part you will make me to know wisdom." So David, he said, "I was brought forth in iniquity." So guess what? God can use and make a king regardless of the circumstances, regardless of what's going on, regardless of any circumstances. But David here is broken. He's very broken. He's very, very broken. And one of the biggest lies that'll creep in whenever we're broken is that our lives, that we've just been given one life and we ought to live it how we want to. Just live it up, right? That's the number one lie that the carnal nature, that the carnal mind is tempted with day in and day out, is that we just have this one life and boy, we better make it good, we better make it right, yada, 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 all that. We don't want to be free because we love our own lives too much. We don't want to be free. We don't want to be set free from any kind of bondage, from anything that we're trapped in, because we love our life. We love the things that we're doing with our lives. We love the constant day-to-day things, the rush of whatever spirit we get, whatever kind of high we get from whatever iniquity we're doing. We love that. It's not love, though. It's not love. And we also think that this God who knows everything about anything and everything around us, including you, we think that he's just called us to figure it all out whenever we make it to the other side one day. Whenever we step into glory, you know, we'll just have it all figured out. While there is some truth to that, hear me out. Hear me out. He has commanded you to know him. He's commanded you to put John 17:3 up on the board. Please, he's commanded you to know him. And guess what? That is eternal life, to know him. And this is eternal life, that they might know you, the one true God, and Jesus Christ, whom he has sent. So don't get hung up in, you know, well, I'll just know one day whenever I make it to heaven. Figure it out now. Try to. Try to figure it out now. If there's something that's bugging you, if there's something that you just can't, try to figure it out now. Why do you say this, Jacob? Here's why I say this. Because we live in a seeker's kingdom. His kingdom is a seeker's kingdom. When you seek things in God's kingdom, guess what happens? You find it. When you seek things in God's kingdom, whenever you truly, humbly, with a broken spirit, with a broken heart, with all that, whenever you seek things, guess what he's going to do? He's your father. He wants you to know. He doesn't want you bound with some lie from hell or with some kind of... No, no. He wants you to know. He wants to give you the revelation knowledge that is in this word somewhere that will come out of the mouth of one of his people. He wants you to know, because he can't stand it whenever his child is bound, whenever his child is just bound by lies. He can't stand it. Whenever you seek, you will find. Whenever you ask, it shall be given unto you. Whenever you knock, it shall be opened. Father, I pray, Lord, I pray that you teach me, Lord. I pray that you give me the knowledge of this. You're knocking. And you're decreeing that I will figure it out. Amen. That I will know. That, Lord, I believe you will give me an answer.
Amen.
Seek. Seek the things that are above. It's a seeker's kingdom.
Yes, God.
And guess what? You're not going to dig any deeper into truth if you don't want to seek it.
That's right.
It's not going to happen.
Amen.
Seek those things which are above. Seek the things that are in the spirit realm that we have to get out of this body and worship him in spirit and truth and walk in the spirit and live in the spirit. Seek those things which are above. Don't wait till you get there to figure it all out. Talking to a room full of soldiers in here. I'm talking to God's army. Seek those things which are above. Have a hunger and a thirst.
Amen.
Want to operate in his kingdom.
Amen.
Want to operate now. So, touching back on those scriptures in Psalms 51 about a broken heart, or the Lord desiring for works or whatever. In that place of brokenness, that's all he wants. He has sovereignly lined up everything. He's used the devil on a chessboard to get everything in line. And if you're in that place, if you're listening, if you're in that place in here, you couldn't be in a better place to know him, to get a fresh revelation of who he is, his heart. But I want to jump now, not in Scripture, but I want to kind of jump topics on a spirit that will creep up on you and a spirit that will deceive you and take you down the wrong path whenever you're in that place of brokenness. So we're talking about repentance. The Bible says that the goodness of God brings man to repentance. The Bible also says that godly sorrow produces repentance, which leads to salvation. Your wholeness. Your protection. Sozo. Somebody give me some more examples. Sozo. Your healing. Made whole. Kept saved. Delivered. All that. You're supposed to work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. But godly sorrow produces repentance. What is godly sorrow? What is godly sorrow? It's that broken place that David was in. It's that broken and that contrite spirit that he was in. So what is repentance really mean? Metanoia in the Greek. Metanoia. What does that mean? What does that mean? Does that mean to just come up here on the altar, ask for prayer, and then go right back out there and remain the same? Metanoia means to change the way that you think. To change the way that you think. Does every thought come from your heart? Does it come from you? No. We should have that established. Not every thought is of you. You have to take captive those thoughts that come from him. You have to know which thoughts are from him and which ones are from the enemy, or which ones are just from you. Change the way you think. Repentance. Okay? So where I'm going with this is many of you in here, you have a significant other. You have a significant other. You have a wife. You have a husband. God has joined you together. You're living a happy life. And I want to testify, y'all probably know that I've just recently got engaged. Praise the Lord. He has been so good. He has joined us together. It's no doubt that it's him, and I have such peace with that. But let me give you some testimony. I was running from a call to preach, to just surrender to God in college. I was running from the call, and one of the hang-ups that I had in my head was, all right, Lord, you send the woman, I'll send you myself. Here you go. That ain't the way. No, 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 no. And listen, here's why. Here's why. Here's the things that he has showed me and taught me. And this is just testimony. This is testimony that you could share with whoever. It might help you. I don't know. I'm just following what the Lord has given me. Here's what will happen. If you are in that place and if you feel like it's going to take the right person to get you on the right path, that right person has already died. He's already given up his spirit. He's already poured his spirit out, shed his blood. He's already done the work. Come on. Come on. Give God praise. So if he would answer your prayer and send you the right person to get you on the right path, guess what? They would become Lord then. They would become Lord. All the good things, you know, all the things that you just, oh, yeah. It's all because of you. That's garbage. That's garbage. That's a very deceiving spirit that will attack you in that place of brokenness. As humans, we were designed to worship. We were designed and made to worship. And there's many things that we can worship. I'm going to get ahead of myself in my notes. But listen here, here's a little tidbit for you. You become more like whatever you worship. Ooh. You become more like whatever you worship. You become more like whatever you worship. That's why we worship the Son. If you've seen Him, you've seen the Father. We want to become more like Jesus. We want to do the things Jesus does. But guess what? If you're not worshiping Him out of your spirit and out of the truth in your worship. So, go back to that scenario I just laid out for you. If God was to grant people's wish with that, their wish, if He was to bless that, and I'm not saying that won't work. Hear me out. I'm not saying that won't work. I'm not saying God can't work that out. I'm just telling you of the spirit that can be behind that scenario. You will stay distant to God. If He blesses you that way, you will stay distant to God. Like I said, if they become your Lord, you will just thank Him and you'll stay distant. You won't step into new life. You won't step into the things that He has prepared for you. It won't happen. It won't happen. He wants you to step into His kingdom. He wants to teach you how to operate in a new way. He wants to teach you how to have a new wine skin. And He wants to pour new wine in it. So that wine doesn't burst out and run all over creation. So it's in you. So you can be a blessing. So you can represent Christ Jesus to the creation. Amen. So let's keep on going. Let's keep on going with this, talking about this deceiving spirit that will attack you, especially if you're single. It will attack you in that place of brokenness. And then you're hoping and believing for that, and let's say someone does come into your life, and then you turn on the dadgum country radio. You turn on the radio, and you get all this mess about, oh, baby, you saved me. You saved me, Or why do I want to go to heaven whenever heaven's laying by me at night? Or why would I want... Y'all know... Hear me out. Come on. Y'all with me? Y'all with me? It's garbage. It's absolute pure garbage. It's pure garbage. It's deception. It is pure deception. You either worship Him or you worship the things of the world. And let's say this has happened to you. Let's say that this scenario that I'm painting has happened to you. You worship the one that lived inside, that lives inside that significant other. You say, Lord Jesus, I thank you. I thank you, Jesus, for my spouse. But God, I thank you that you've shed your blood, that you've forgiven me of everything I've ever done, that you have washed me clean, that you've given me a new name, that you've given me a new heart, that you've put in me a new spirit. God, I praise you for it. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. That's worship. That's worship. You begin to decree and proclaim who you are now that you're in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Man. I just get so mad whenever I hear this stuff on the radio. And I think that at one point in my life I fell for it. That's why you see a mad man up here. It's because I fell for it one time. I fell for it. It's lies from hell, people. There's a spirit behind that. It feels so right. It feels so good. And it seems right. And it seems like it's the way. But it's not the way. It is not the way. There's one way. There's one way. And y'all hear me with grace right now because I'm about to probably prick somebody's heart. If you don't like it, if you don't like what you're about to hear, come to me afterwards. We'll work it all out. But I'm just going to impart truth to you right now. Okay? And then we listen. We have all this stuff playing in our kids. It's getting in our kids' hearts. It's getting in your children's hearts. And then they grow up and they have a foggy, they don't know the goodness of God. They don't know the goodness of God. They don't know that there is a spirit behind that they're blind to. No condemnation. Hear me with grace. Hear me with grace. Not the end of the world. Repent. Change the way you think. It's that simple. The blood's powerful. The blood will either forgive you and cleanse you of everything, or it does nothing. There's a spirit behind it. But we go down the road blaring this mess out of just pure ignorance, blindness. And it's getting in your kids' hearts, getting in your hearts. And you may say, oh, well, I just listen to the melodies of the song, you know, the lyrics. No, the lyrics are getting in you. The lyrics in music, the way God, this is just kind of my revelation of music. God gave everybody musical talents. Music does something to your soul, okay? It does something to your soul. I believe, truly, this, don't wrap a doctrine around this, I believe God designed music so it could open up your soul and then words could get imparted directly into your heart. Because music, the lyrics in music, they don't just get in your brain, they get in your heart. They go directly to your heart. And man, if it's garbage, if it's lies from hell, it's getting right into your heart. It's getting right into your loved one's heart. Change it. Change the way you think. Change the way you think. Guess what that's going to do? That's going to change the way you live. And guess what that's going to happen? That's going to usher you into freedom. Talk about being blind. Turn to 2 Kings. This is the last little bit of scripture we're going to look at. 2 Kings chapter 6. 2 Kings chapter 6 verse 14 through 18. And this is what I'm talking about being blind. And there may be some of you parents out there that have condemnation knocking on your door right now. Like, wow, I have not done that. Or I have done that. No, don't be condemned. Each and every person has to wake up for themselves and they have to realize it. You can't save your kids. You can't walk out your own kids to salvation. They have to wake up and they have to make a decision in their heart to either receive truth or to write it off. But in 2 Kings chapter 6, verses 14 through 18, I'm going to read it out of the New King James because that's just follow along. This is Elisha the prophet, and this is some man that comes to him, and there's an army that's about to surround them. He says, therefore he sent horses and chariots and a great army there, and they came by night and surrounded the city. The city that Elisha and them were in. And when the servant of the man of God is Elisha, they arose early and went out, and there was an army surrounding the city with horses and chariots. And his servant said to him, "Alas, my master, what shall we do?" So he answered, "Do not fear." Boy, that'll preach. "Do not fear, for those who are with us are more than those who are with them." Lord Jesus. "For those who are with us are more than those who are with them." What's he talking about? There's an army of chariots and horses and madmen about to slay them at the sound of their commander. And Elisha says, keep reading. Here we go. And Elisha prayed and said, "Lord, I pray, open his eyes that he may see." And then the Lord opened the eyes of the young man and he saw. Oh. And behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elisha. So when the Syrians came down to him, Elisha prayed to the Lord and said, "Strike this people, I pray, with blindness." And he struck them with blindness according to the what of Elisha? To the word. Oh, we've been talking about words and the power of our words on Wednesday nights. But the gist of that little piece of scripture is there's something going on around us that we can't see. And we sure are not going to see it if we remain bound and if we remain carnal and if we remain in our flesh. There's things that we're not going to see. Lord, I pray that you open the eyes of this man so he can see. So he can see. I want to do that. Father, I pray right now, Lord Jesus, that if there's anybody in here, Lord, I pray that you open their eyes, Lord. Lord, I pray that spiritual discernment sweep this place, Lord. I pray that people open their eyes and they see you and that they see the things of God in a new, in a living way by the blood of Jesus. Lord, I pray for that impartation right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Man just couldn't see. But whenever Elisha, the man of God, prayed, "Lord, please open their eyes," he saw the chair. He saw that, boy, we are okay. We have an angel army behind us, God's army. Listen here. 1/3 of heaven's angels fell. So guess what that means? For every demon you may battle, 2 of God's angels are there, outnumbering it. You've been ushered into victory. You've been ushered into new life, into freedom. I pray that if anyone's eyes have not been opened, if you don't see the things of God, I pray that that changes today. Because whenever I testify of my own life, whenever I started to see and understand that there's a whole nother realm around us, and we've been given ways and tactics to operate in God's kingdom. We've been given these ways by looking at the life of Jesus and realize that he did it as a man empowered by the Spirit of God, operating in God's kingdom. And see, here's the thing. This life is preparing us for the next life, for glory. It's preparing us. We've been called to know him now. We've been called to learn to operate now. To operate. Like Brother Randy said a while back, he said, you're not just going to be floating on a cloud one day, you know, off somewhere. We're going to be servants. I don't know what it's going to be like, but we have to learn now. I'm not saying God's not gracious and mercy and merciful. Learn now. It's life. It's life more abundantly. I've given you eternal life. And I've seated you in heavenly places with me, far above all principalities, powers of there, all above Satan's kingdom. You're above it because you're seated with the Lord Jesus Christ in heavenly places. Father, we praise you. We praise you and we worship you this morning, Lord. Father, I thank you for the power of your word. I thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit. I thank you, Lord, for what you did for us. I thank you for shedding your blood and pouring your spirit in us so we could see, so we can be the new creation, the house that is fit for a king. God, I thank you for what you've done. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's all stand. As we have invitation this morning, if you don't know the Lord Jesus, come forward. Come forward. Come forward. Come while it's still today. While it's still called today. Come. Come. New life. A new name. Come. Believing for chains to be broken in Jesus' name. Believing for bondages to be broken in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling for you and for me. See,
you need prayer for healing, you need prayer for anything financial, it doesn't matter, come forward. Come forward.
Watching for you,
praise you, Jesus,
and for me. Come home. Come home. Ye who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, oh sinner, come home. Oh, for the wonderful love he has promised, promised for you and for me. Though we have sinned, he has mercy and pardoned, pardoned for you and for me. Come home, come home. Ye who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, oh sinner, come home, come home, come home. Ye who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, oh sinner, come home.
This morning, lay it down. Come to the Lord Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. If you're weary, if you're burdened down with weariness, with fatigueness, with anxiety, it all bows to the name of Jesus.
Softly and tenderly, Jesus, he's calling. Calling for you and for me. See on the portal. watching for you and for me. Come home, oh, come home. Ye who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, oh, sinner.